Hello creators! Are you on social media? Then you've probably noticed that most brand videos on your timeline are square-shaped. That's because they look more authentic on small screens and create a better experience. If you want to learn how to create square videos for social media, this is what today's tutorial is all about. As an example, we'll create a new style video with text over image. Let's get started. Launch VSDC and create a project for social network of your choice. For this tutorial, we choose Twitter. From the drop-down menu, select a 640x640 portrait resolution. Click Finish. Now add a background photo. Apply auto cropping to resize it. Now it takes the entire scene. Perfect! Go to the Video Effects menu and add Zoom. In the Properties window, find Zoom Settings Levels and switch to the Linear Parameter Change mode. Change the second value to 110 and go back to the first tab on the timeline. The next step is to prepare a base for text. There are two ways to do it. First, you can darken the video by reducing its level of transparency. Option number two is to add a bit of gradient, and that's exactly what we are going to do. Add a rectangle-shaped object to the scene. Adjust its size to 1/2 or 3/4 of the video. Choose the rectangle style number 3, filled without borders. Then go to the Properties window, scroll down to the Brush menu and switch to Gradient Background. Now open the Gradient Settings menu. In the pop-up window, find Templates and from the drop-down menu, select Neutral Density. Choose any gradient style to your taste. Click OK. Adjust the gradient vector. You want the lower part of the rectangle to be darker than the upper area. Done! Let's move on and add text. Add a text object to the scene using the icon on the left-hand side. Change its font and size. To make your text fit the placeholder, use the Wrap tool and switch trimming mode to Word. This way, if the text doesn't fit in a particular line, the app will break it down by words. You can also make editing more convenient by using auto-sizing. Let's highlight the title. Select the first couple of words and apply a brighter color to them. Now drag the text object outside of the scene. Make a double click on it on the timeline and add movement. Stretch the movement vector to point out the final position of the text in the video. Go back to the timeline and drag the final keyframe to the half a second benchmark. Voila! If you like this tutorial, don't forget to give us a thumbs up and subscribe. Many more awesome videos are ahead, so stay tuned!